What's up, everybody? My name is Max Feinstein, and I'm an anesthesia resident at the Mount Sinai Hospital in New York City. In this video, I'm going to be taking you on a guided tour of what I think is one of the most fascinating operating rooms, which is liver transplant surgery. Without further ado, let's step on in. As you can tell, there's a lot to see in this operating room, and so I'm going to break it down for you piece by piece. And since I'm an anesthesiology resident, I'm of course going to have a big focus on everything related to anesthesia. Starting with this IV pole, you can see that we have a lot of drips set up here, and these are actually all vasopressors. Which include vasopressin, norepinephrine, epinephrine, and a line to run all these in. All of these vasopressors come together into one set of stopcocks here, which goes into one single IV, which will go through a central line. Panning over to the anesthesia machine, you can see that on top we have a cerebral oximeter, which isn't used in all cases, but is used mostly for fulminant hepatic failure patients when we're concerned about increased intracranial pressure or cerebral edema or herniation, or anytime we're worried about cerebral perfusion pressure. Next to the cerebral oximeter is a bispectral index monitor, which we use routinely in lots of cases, not just in liver transplants. And then beneath that, you can see a standard monitor that would be found in pretty much any operating room, our ventilator controls. You'll notice that there are several emergency medications strategically placed on the cart here. And this is a normal breathing circuit that would be found in pretty much any type of operating room. We have a suction canister, suction, absorbent. And then all of our airway equipment, including a direct laryngoscopy blade, an endotracheal tube, monitors, and this is what a bispectral index monitor looks like. Right next to the anesthesia machine is a defibrillator. Liver transplant surgeries can get extremely involved, and in some cases, patients can become hemodynamically unstable or even go into cardiac arrest, necessitating defibrillation. So a defibrillator is always close by. Panning right next to the anesthesia machine, you can see our anesthesia cart, which has a lot of medications drawn up and ready to go for the case that's about to happen in this room. Medications shown here include atropine, glycopyrrolate, phenylephrine, ephedrine, epinephrine, norepinephrine, insulin, nitroglycerin, bicarbonate, calcium chloride, lidocaine, fentanyl, propofol, midazolam, rocuronium, and succinylcholine. Opening up the cart, you can see that we have a lot more medications that we keep nearby. And you can actually click this link up here for a guided tour of this medication cart by Dr. Erica Fagelman, who's one of our liver transplant anesthesia attendings at Mount Sinai, and also one of our assistant program directors. Next to the anesthesia cart, you'll see this transesophageal echocardiography setup. TEE is used very commonly in liver transplant anesthesia. It's worth pointing out that our liver transplant anesthesia fellows get certified in the use of TEE. This is what the scope looks like, which is inserted down a patient's esophagus once they're under general anesthesia, so that the anesthesiologist can get a very good view of the patient's heart and liver. The other IV pole has a pressure bag set up with transducers for invasive lines like arterial lines, and also additional IV bags for other infusions. One of the things I'll point out about this bed is that the anesthesiologist actually has the remote to control the bed positioning, which affects not only the ergonomics of the surgeon, but can also have really important hemodynamic implications for patients, and if positioned incorrectly, patients can also end up with nerve damage. Just next to the anesthesia cart is a large supply of albumin, which is commonly used for volume resuscitation during liver transplant surgery, along with blood products if the patient is willing to accept blood products. And then going to the rest of the operating room, you can see that there's surgical equipment, including electrocautery equipment, needles, sutures, gloves. These tables will eventually be used to put sterile operating equipment on. And on the other side of the operating room, you'll see a blood gas analyzer, which is used very frequently during liver transplant surgery to analyze many different components of the patient's blood, which can help guide decision-making in the operating room during surgery. On this Mayo stand, you'll see several kits that are used to place central lines. Doing procedures like placing central lines is something that attracts a lot of people to anesthesiology and is a big component of doing liver transplant anesthesiology. Behind the anesthesia machine is a hookup for all of the gases that come from the central supply in the hospital. These all get hooked up to the anesthesia machine, and we have backup tanks for them as well. What's not shown in the operating room, but will be brought in right before surgery, is this device called a Belmont rapid transfuser, which, as the name implies, can do large volume fluid resuscitation in a very short period of time. These types of devices can be seen in other types of surgeries that necessitate large amounts of volume resuscitation, for example, trauma surgery. Another device commonly used during surgeries where a lot of blood loss is anticipated is an auto transfusion system, like the Sorin Extra. This device allows us to recapture blood that has been lost during surgery, filter it, and then transfuse it back to the patient so that we can minimize the amount of blood product that needs to be given from donors. Well, that wraps up this tour of the liver transplant operating room, and I think this is one of the most fascinating types of surgeries to participate in as an anesthesiologist because there's so much that goes on and it can be a pretty intense surgery. Mount Sinai is actually one of the busiest liver transplant centers in the United States, and the Department of Anesthesiology has a fellowship where anesthesiologists who have finished their residency can come and get subspecialty training in liver transplant anesthesia. Special thanks to Dr. Erica Fagelman for her help making this video, and thank you for watching. I'll see you next time.